for New Westminster.
Honorable Speaker, 9 minutes is the benchmark set for ambulance response times for the most urgent calls to 911. Yet a recent study by BC Emergency Health Services of Metro Vancouver, Greater Victoria, and the Fraser Valley shows that ambulances are failing to reach patients within that 9 minutes half the time. Can the Premier explain why her government is making half of the most urgent patients wait longer than they should for an ambulance to arrive?
Minister of Finance.
Thanks, Madam Speaker. I'll take the question on notice for the Health Minister.
Member for New Westminster on a supplemental.
Honourable Speaker, a new question to the Premier. This Premier always waits until there's a crisis before her government acts. And that's the case with the latest so-called plan released by the government last week. And I encourage the Premier to take a good look at that plan, because even with this new plan, ambulances will fail to reach 1 in 4 of the most urgent patients within the accepted benchmark, and even that modest goal won't be met until the year 2020, 4 years from now. Is that what passes for being number one in this Premier's eyes? Last week, the Heart and Stroke Foundation told members from both sides of this House that after waiting 12 minutes for defibrillation, the survival rate for stroke patients is less than 5%. So again to the Premier, why has she failed to ensure that patients have the ambulance services that they need when their health and their lives could be at risk?
Madam Premier.
Madam Speaker, the the Finance Minister has taken the substance of that question on notice on behalf of the Minister of Health, but I do want to speak to part of it, because the member referenced what passes for number one in Canada, and I do have an answer for that. I'll tell you what passes for number one: creating 50,000 new jobs in the last year, which leads Canada bar none. In economic growth in the coming year and projected to do so in the years thereafter, that means we are number one. Healthcare outcomes that have been demonstrated by outside agencies in Canada and around the world to lead the world as amongst the best anywhere, and by the way, at the lowest cost, amongst the lowest cost per capita, that also makes us number one. And having our fourth consecutive balanced budget with over $1.6 billion in new spending for people who are vulnerable, with billions of dollars in capital spending to support the creation of jobs in our province, and most of all, Madam Speaker, it's a tireless, purposeful focus on making sure that we get to yes on economic development so that we can protect and create jobs, not just for British Columbians, but for the thousands of Canadians who are coming across the Rockies looking for work in a province that in Canada today is absolutely, without question, number one.